So I have a little over a terabyte of Cyberpunk footage kind of just eating up space on one of my hard drives. I'm about 40 hours into the game, but I haven't played it for months and I don't know if I'm ever gonna go back to it. But I do want to talk about my impressions of the game, and I also don't want to just delete the footage since it's already been sitting there for months, and if I was gonna delete it, I could have just done it already. So that's what we're gonna do in this video. There is no script, so I'm gonna be all over the place, but I've probably got about two or three good bullet points worth talking about in here. So as per the usual on this channel, we are going to start with the positives and then work our way down to the stuff that I'm not so crazy about. In general, this game is very okay. So when we do get down to the negatives, it's not really going to be stuff that I hate about the game. More so stuff that probably should have just been a little better given how long it took for them to make this game. But for now, we're on the positives. And to start, you have to applaud how ambitious this game is. This is a huge game. Like I said, I'm about 40 hours in and I think I'm only about halfway through the game. As I previously said, I'm someone that likes to do everything in these open world games, so essentially as soon as I get a new side quest or new contract or something, I immediately did it. And even like side quests and mini objectives aside, there's just a lot of stuff to explore. There's like five different subsections of Night City that all have like different biomes and different NPCs and stuff, and 40 hours in, there's still one or two of them that I haven't even really started to explore. And unlike some other open world games, it doesn't really suffer from the problem of having a huge map that has nothing in it. Night City feels incredibly lived in and fleshed out, so the world and scope of Cyberpunk is definitely a positive. Cyberpunk also has a cast of really interesting characters, and not all of these characters are in the game for the same amount of time, but you will learn more about them as you complete side missions for them, and they all feel like real individual people. Which might sound like a weird thing to bring up, but in a lot of RPGs, you'll get side quests from just like random one-off NPCs, and there's not a lot of that in Cyberpunk. Most of the side quests that you get from a character are part of a chain of side quests, so you'll see that character at least a couple more times throughout the game. And as a result, I ended up feeling some type of way about most of the side characters in this game. I definitely did not like all of them. I feel like some of them you're not meant to like, but it is good that they are invoking some type of emotion from the player. And the last thing I want to talk about as an overall positive is that for me personally, Cyberpunk ran pretty great, which I know is crazy given all of the horror stories from when this game first came out, but for me personally, it ran great since day one. I am on PC and I have a pretty good rig, so that definitely plays a part in why it was running so well for me, but I ran it at 1440p 60fps while recording and I didn't even really get that many frame drops. The only glitches that I can even think about are a couple times the fast travel stations were broken, so like I could access the map but I couldn't actually fast travel anywhere, and I would just restart my game and everything worked fine again. Obviously, if you bought this game on PlayStation 4 or Xbox, bless your soul, you definitely did not have the same experience as I did, but like I said, for me, it ran surprisingly good. Now we're on to the not so hot stuff. The big one for me, which is another thing that might surprise you, is I didn't really like the combat in Cyberpunk. It's really first-person shooter-y, which like I get, it's a first-person shooter, but I also feel like they could have done a lot more with the Cyberpunk elements. The smart weapons are easily the most Cyberpunk-esque weapons in the game. They're probably a little broken now that I'm thinking about it, but it doesn't change the fact that it is cool to like lock onto a person and literally shoot your gun behind you and the bullets just curve and find their targets anyway. But that's like all I can think of in terms of futuristic weapons. There are weapons that you can charge up to get higher power shots, but that's nothing new. And honestly, other than that, most of the weapons are just run-of-the-mill shotguns, assault rifles, and pistols. Overall, I will say that the shooting feels good. There are situations in which, since it's an RPG and enemies have like scaling health, you'll have a shotgun and you'll pump someone in the face three times and they're still kicking. That's always weird in like every shooter RPG. And there are also melee weapons, but we gotta talk about melee weapons in first-person shooters. Melee weapons in first-person shooters are almost never fun. They can be a nice departure from the regular shooting if you're tired of using the same types of guns. But in general, we gotta come up with something different for the melee weapons in first-person shooters. Give me like some cool takedowns or like 10 different swinging animations so I'm not literally doing the same two every time I want to use a melee weapon. But that does segue into one of the more important speaking points that I have written down, which is that I really want to see what this game looked like in third person. Cyberpunk started as a third person game, but they changed it to first person because they wanted it to be more immersive, which I understand, but I honestly feel like every part of combat would have worked better as a third person game. We just got done talking about melee weapons. You can make so many different melee weapon animations in a third person game. There are literally hundreds of them in The Last of Us 2. Is it more work? Yes, but it also makes the game more fun to play. I think that the in-combat hacking would be a lot more intuitive in third person since you'd have more vision. And the stealth in Cyberpunk is absolute dog shit. Enemies have pretty respectable health pools, so a lot of the time when you're in stealth, even with all of the bonuses that you get from attacking someone from stealth, a lot of the times you'll pop them in the head and they just won't die, and now you're no longer in stealth. I have a predominantly stealth built character, and I still will be in stealth, have 3 or 4 bonus damage multipliers, pop someone in the face with a pretty high powered weapon, and it only does like 60% of their health. You can choose different melee augments for your character, and even the monowire, which is supposed to be the stealth augment, is absolutely terrible. In one of the first gameplays that they released, V used the monowire to hack into someone and like take control of the security systems or something like that. That is not in the game at all. It's literally just whipping animations that are less effective than your regular melee. Why would I ever use this? The game's base movement systems also really mess up stealth. You can double tap W, A, S, or D to do a quick dash in that direction, which is good in melee combat, but when you're stealthing and you're trying to micro adjust and you accidentally type the same direction a little too fast, V will still do the dash, at which point if you are by an enemy, you have officially exited stealth. Remember, I haven't played this game for a couple months, so maybe they've patched all this stuff out. I don't know, but I do know that when I was playing, all of this was very not fun for me. The story of Cyberpunk can also be a little confusing at times, which is probably partly my fault because I was taking pretty decent breaks from the game, but also if the game was more fun, I probably wouldn't have been taking such long breaks. Multiple times I found myself just like running toward map objectives, not really knowing what was going on. There's also like some weird continuity stuff. Minor spoilers, I guess? Kinda not really, because it happens like in the first hour of the game. But V is infected with a virus that is killing them. One minute you'll be talking to Johnny, coughing up blood, and like barely holding on to consciousness. And then the next minute, you're fighting a bulked up cyberpunk version of Abby perfectly fine. It's definitely not something that like ruins the gameplay experience, but considering the fact that they changed the game from third person to first person to make it more immersive, and then you've got stuff like that multiple times throughout the game, it's a little weird. And the last thing I have on here is I didn't ever really feel compelled to level up. And that's because for the most part, instead of unlocking like physical skills, like being able to dual wield pistols or like specialized stealth takedowns, most of your skill points go into very incrementally increasing your already possessed abilities. We're talking stuff like 5% bonus headshot damage from stealth or more carrying capacity. This makes leveling up kind of boring since most of the time you aren't really getting new stuff, but I will say that there is a lot of room for build diversity here. There is nothing stopping you from completely maxing out two opposite ends of the skill tree. You can pretty much build your character however you want, and you can buy respecs at Ripper Docks. They do be a little expensive, but at least the option is there. And that is all of the notes that I have about Cyberpunk 2077. Like I said earlier, overall, the game's pretty inoffensive, but what is offensive is how long it was hyped up and dangled in front of us, and how many delays we had to go through, and it finally got here, and it's straight up not working for some people. It's a glitchy mess for other people, and even still, for the people that the game is working for, the actual game itself is just aight. CD Projekt Red has been updating the game as far as I can tell. I don't know how much better it is now than when I was playing, but it is good to see that they're putting in some type of effort to correct their mistakes. I think they've also gone on record saying that they're not going to be hyping up games for 10-11 years anymore, which is good. But yeah, that's about it. There's not really a point to this video. I just wanted to talk about my viewpoints on Cyberpunk. If I ever go back and finish the game, I might do a follow-up to this. I'm definitely not gonna do like one of my regular style reviews, because before you even see this video, the terabyte of Cyberpunk footage is going to be yeeted off my hard drive. But that's a huge if, because there's a very high percentage chance that I'm not ever gonna come back to this game. So if I were you, I probably wouldn't count on that. But what you can count on is me streaming over at twitch.tv/AdonisDelta.
So that was a fucking lie.
As is always the case, the link to my Twitch and other socials will be in the description. If you liked the video, be sure to leave a like and sub to the channel for more content like this. And leave a comment for the algorithm. Tell me how you feel about Cyberpunk. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one.